The biggest question we were trying to answer since day one with the Samsung Galaxy S4 Zoom is whether we are using a phone with a zoom lens enabled camera or a camera with a phone attached. Needless to say, people were shocked, curious, and intrigued to see us taking and placing calls on it. The S4 Zoom is the last Samsung device announced at the Premier 2013 London event that we are reviewing now. To check out our Galaxy S4 Active and Galaxy S4 Mini reviews, head over to Pocket Now. And also, subscribe to our social media channels to stay up to date. The Samsung Galaxy S4 Zoom, provided to us by our good friends at clove.co.uk, arrived at our doorstep on July 15, meaning we've used it exclusively as our daily driver over the course of 10 days. Just enough time to answer the phone camera dilemma. However, we instantly concluded that, aside from the name, the S4 Zoom has nothing to do with the Galaxy S4. It's a Galaxy Camera, Galaxy S4 Mini crossover. On the outside, it looks like a Galaxy S4 Mini if you look at the front. If you turn it to the side or to the back, it looks like a point-and-shoot, a Galaxy Camera. The same design is being used, or overused, and the same materials grace your fingers, hyperglazed polycarbonate with S4-like textures. If we assume you've never seen another Samsung phone in the past 2 years, we can describe it to you. There's an earpiece up top, above the Samsung branding, flanked by the sensors and the webcam. Below there's a 4.3-inch QHD screen, and the bottom holds the obligatory home button with the capacitive back and menu shortcuts to its left and right. That's about it as far as the phone part is concerned. All the rest can easily be subject to a camera hardware tour. There's even a tripod mount on the left side, together with a microSD expansion slot and a lanyard hole, power button, volume rockers, and a two-stage camera button on the right side, micro USB port on the bottom, with a flap to access the slide-in battery and micro SIM tray. There's also a 3.5mm headphone jack, IR blaster, and a secondary microphone on the top. The back is dominated by the huge Samsung-made zoom lens. It offers 10x optical zoom, and it extends quite a bit. The camera itself also has optical image stabilization, focus assist light, and a xenon flash. Near the lens, on the back, there's your speaker grille. And yes, there's a camera grip, which is tipping the scales, and this is a camera with a phone statement's favor. Under the hyperglazed polycarbonate, there's a 4.3-inch Super AMOLED screen with QHD resolution, which is 960x540, a 1.5GHz dual-core processor, 1.5GB of RAM, 8GB of internal storage, out of which 5 usable of course, expandable, a 16MP main camera on the back with 10x optical zoom and xenon flash, 1.9MP webcam, 2330mAh battery, and Android 4.2.2 Jelly Bean with TouchWiz on top of it. Other specs include Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, NFC, as well as 3G and LTE capable radios. As far as software is concerned, everything is similar to the Galaxy S4 Mini, which is similar to the Galaxy S4. If you want to know about the details, make sure to check out those reviews. We'll now focus on the differences and new camera-oriented additions. The overall looks, feel, functionality, and user experience is identical though. Probably the most talked about feature of the S4 Zoom is its camera ring. While in camera mode, you can use the ring to zoom in or out, but while you're anywhere else, twisting it brings up a special screen with some camera modes you can choose from. Use the ring to navigate the modes and jump straight into the camera app in order to shoot using that particular mode. While in a phone call, twist the ring to enter the in-call photo share feature, which enables you to quickly snap a shot and send it to your contact, the one you're on a call with. There are specific photo and camera-oriented applications bundled, like Photo Suggest, that places you on a map and shows you other pictures shot in your vicinity, and Story Album, which unfortunately crashed on our review unit upon launch, but it should enable you to create slideshows and show off your stills. Probably the most important and different part of the software is the camera application. You can launch it by holding down the shutter button, but unfortunately only when the phone is unlocked. No Windows Phone-like quick picture taken here. Launch the camera and the lens will extend on the back. From there you have to make a choice, shoot in auto mode, smart mode, or one of the three expert modes. Auto mode lets the camera decide of how to shoot under those current conditions. Smart mode allows you to choose one of 25 existing shooting modes, but advanced photographers will probably want to use one of the three expert modes. Program mode, which adjusts the exposure by setting the shutter speed and aperture values. Manual mode for manually setting the previous values. Or color wizard for setting the color by manually changing brightness, color saturation, contrast, and sharpness. There are a ton of settings you can play with. Samsung's latest TouchWiz user interface runs on top of Android 4.2.2, whether you like it or not. It is, however, snappy. Even in the software department, the S4 Zoom looks and acts like an S4, give or take a couple of things like the missing LED notification, AirView, and Air Gesture. You won't find S Health either, and the keyboard, just like on the S4 Mini, is a 4-row input panel instead of the 5-row keyboard on the S4. The rest is the same. We strongly encourage you to check out both the S4 and S4 Mini reviews for more details. We've used the Samsung Galaxy S4 Zoom over the course of 10 days. While this is no powerhouse, it will manage to do everything you throw at it, though occasionally you'll have to wait a second for heavy tasks to finish. With our regular usage, we got more than a day's worth of battery life out of the 2330mAh pack, which is powering the phone, or camera. We're talking about phone calls, text messages, social media on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, taking pictures, browsing the web, instant messaging, Google Maps, YouTube videos, Spotify music, and even workout tracking. You will definitely get at least one day's worth of action of the S4 Zoom. That is, if you're not too heavy on the camera. Those zoom lens and the xenon flash really drain your battery if you're abusing the shutter button. To say that the Galaxy S4 Zoom is the best camera we have ever used on a phone is an overstatement, and it will definitely raise heated discussions and debates. It is, however, right there in the top. You can't go wrong with its pictures, and with heavy advanced customizations and shooting modes, you can also unleash your creativity. Thanks to the physical optical zoom lens, Samsung didn't need to go with Nokia's or a similar approach in terms of huge megapixel sensors. 16 megapixels is more than enough for the images generated, and the lens, zoomed in or not, give you great quality, clarity, saturation, and sharpness. We'll leave you with some more samples playing in the background, while we tell you that voice and data performance was also good. We experienced no problems at all. Earpiece performance was good, and so did our voice sound over the microphone. Speakerphone is loud, thanks to the fairly large speaker on the back, regardless if you're using it for calls or music. We wish the Galaxy S4 Zoom had a 720p display. We wish it had a slightly faster processor, at least double the internal storage, and yes, we wish it had an LED notification light. It's time to draw our conclusion. Regardless of how much Samsung would like you to believe otherwise, we think that the Galaxy S4 Zoom is a camera with a phone slapped on it, rather than a Galaxy S4, with which it has absolutely nothing in common, with a zoom lens attached. As for the pros, the GS4 Zoom is definitely something you want to get if you are into a device that delivers everything phone and camera. There are, of course, other solutions out there. The bigger brother, the Galaxy S4, the main competitor, the HTC One, are also great camera solutions. Not to mention Windows Phone with its Lumia 1020, and the good old iPhone 5. If you decide to go with a GS4 Zoom, you will not be disappointed. Because of all the aforementioned, we are rating the Galaxy S4 Zoom an 8.2 out of 10.